In yesterday's video, I said that we received a 3-pack of figs on 7/14 this year, the day before the feast starts. And that was actually 11 years later after we arrived in Greece on 7/14, before the feast began on then the Danites calendar, that of course is an unrestored calendar that's not been restored. But 7/14 on his restored calendar, we received this 3-pack of figs. Well, they came from Turkey. Well, he sent the dual wives of Zechariah 5 back from Greece via Turkey. But these figs are called Smyrna figs. And it ties into, I said yesterday, the revelations of Yahweh's two sons of his holy anointing oil with the called out ones of Smyrna. When he says Satan's going to put some of us in prison for 10 days with those called out ones from Smyrna. Amazing, because that 10 days would take us to yesterday's 7/24 waypoint. And of course would end this morning because the night belongs to the previous day but on our maker's calendar. Anyway, it's quite remarkable, because we've of course been bound all along. This is a day of small things, and he hasn't opened wide my mouth, which he's going to give me the opening wide of my mouth with uncovering the arm in association with 40 days that I believe followed yesterday, which of course that would make today day number one of those 40 days of Ezekiel chapter 4 then, of my lion on my right side, and I'm going to expand upon that. But remarkable, they came through, he sent them back via Turkey and these Smyrna figs, and here we have them. We actually got them back to the Mount of Olives with the rolling thing 2 days later on 7/16, which 10 days from when we got them back to the Mount of Olives would be tomorrow, 7/26, which is the day that I received the gold for the dual wives, which weren't the dual wives yet at that point, but to make the golden belt of Daniel chapter 10. But all remarkable, because the being bound is what this is all about. And of course, the 3.5 days I talked about that flowed out from yesterday morning at 7:34 a.m. were already over 1 day into them as well. But they got out of the plane on 1/22 here in the chief seat of the scattered descendants of Israel, aka America, aka Nineveh, aka the capital of Mystery Babylon. But they were fled to tents the next day on the 123rd day of the year, tying into Daniel's 21st day of the toothache on 1/23, and that 49th day of the 490 that set forth the 1260-day clock that ended yesterday morning at 7:34 a.m. But that day, when that day number 123, when they went to dwell in tents, was 7/24 on Satan's calendar, and 5/03 on Yahweh's then. That was his restored calendar, but 7/24 on Satan's calendar. Wow, 5 days after when they got pitched to tents, days after that 7/19 waypoint. It was 7/24. Yesterday was 7/24 on his restored calendar. It's truly remarkable how he's done all this. But these Turkish figs, that's amazing. Smyrna figs, but from Turkey. They're made in Turkey, it says on the package. But ties in the year, the Yeshua's parable of the fig tree, which he keeps on uncovering more and more of. Because on 4/02, I did that fourth application over the course of 5 days of those fig trees with those boils he gave me. And amazing, because 4/02 is day number 92. Well, 92 days after the third dove was the 56th day from when he told his servant Noah to remove the covering, which was 2/27. And but that's 92 days after the third dove, the dove that didn't return to the boat. But I used 15 figs over the course of those four applications of those 5 days, and quite remarkable, because Hezekiah had 15 years added to his life, and he used the vehicle of a fig ointment for that healing in association with the 10 degrees, turning the sundial back, his father Ahaz, the sundial back 10 degrees, which of course altered the rotations of the luminaries, and now it's about his restored calendar, his restored 30-day months. So it's quite remarkable with the 10 days that either ended this morning here after yesterday's 10th day, or 2 days from now, which would be the next morning on 7:34 a.m. on 7/27. And I talked about that waypoint yesterday. And of course, 7:34 p.m. that night is the end of the 3 1/2 days. But Hezekiah's 39 years of his life, when he was sick unto death, added the 15 years, to bring him to 54 years old when he died. The sundial, 10 degrees, with these 10 days with the fig tree, is amazing because, again, Hezekiah used, the fig ointment to heal Hezekiah's boils. Quite amazing. Heal my boils in 402, day number 92 of the year, plus 3 months and 22 days was yesterday. Tonight's Powerball drawing is 322 million, which I'll get to here as we go on. But the last Powerball was the draw numbers that he caused to be drawn, and he's proven he's caused every one of these now, 113 draws, the numbers to be drawn. He's testified to it. It's impossible to refute, including, I'll just give you an example of one small example. But the last Powerball he caused to be drawn were 27, which ties into other things recently too, but that's not the focus of this video, the three nines and such of it. But then, because three nines are in 27, and that ties into the first day of the count 50 and a whole bunch of stuff, but I don't want to get into it. Day number 69 of the year, and which there's 69 sevens of the, until you get to the final seven, and I'm already getting into more and I want to get into, so I'm going to skip right there. Second number that in the order from the least to the greatest that was drawn, that last Powerball drawing, was the number 39 for Hezekiah's 39 years. The next one was 54 for the 15 years added to him to when he went to sleep with his fathers in the 54th year. The next number was 56 for the 56th day when he opened the door of the three tiers of the boat. 56 days, which was that 92nd day from the third dove. And the third number was 59, and excuse me, the fifth number was 50, fifth ball was 59, the fifth smooth stone, I should say, was 59. And when I see the number 59, one thing always jumps front and center to my mind, and that's Isaiah 59, when he says he's going to cause nothing that I've spoken, or my seed, or my seed's seed has spoken, to depart. So that day is coming. But the Powerball was number 24. So that was the numbers of the last Powerball. And all that is significant, but the reason I point out today is because the numbers are the three of the five, which were 39, 54, and 56, with what I just shared with you. Well, last night's Mega Million total, he caused the six balls to total 181. He used three places, and it's the firebrand of his Meher Shalal Kushbash prophecy, and it's also the firebrand of those two firebrands of his Meher Shalal Kushbash prophecy, and it's the firebrand of his servant Zerubbabel, Yeshua dwelling in me, of Zechariah chapter 3. Who is this brand plucked from the fire? So it's that firebrand of the brand plucked from the fire, clothed in filthy garments, standing before your faces. So that's last night's total, Mega Million. Of course, he didn't cause his numbers that his Urim and Thummim have given me to line up, because it increased to 18 million, which I'm getting to. But the five balls of last night's drawing totaled, the five smooth stones totaled 158 last night. Yesterday was the 608th day that the manual man-child Meher Shalal Kushbaz and his twin sister Rachel been in the womb. Wow, he caused his 608 was day number 158, is day number 158 of the year on our Maker's restored calendar. That's the day that he caused his servant, well, when Yahweh's servant Moses found out his faces were shining, that 81st day. Parallel in the 81st court case number that I talked about yesterday's video, I believe, or the day before's, and a whole slew of things. The 81 days that separate his Abraham lamp and his dual double lamps, and the cubit at the top of the third tier of the boat is called a dual double light, which is translated noon, with the darkness that typically translated noon or middle of the day, but dual double lights. Day number 158 total, the five balls yesterday on the 608th day for Meher and Shalal Kushbaz. 608 on his restored calendar. Again, this is all about his restored calendar because it contains his restored appointed times, including his restored Sabbath in it. This is about you turning back to his Sabbath and his restored appointed times first and foremost. This is just reality. And this is a great Meher Shalal Kushbaz mirroring on things is amazing, especially how it mirrors on Satan's calendar sometimes and the Danite's unrestored calendar. But day number one, this ain't no mirror on Satan's counter. This is just mirroring the number 158 to what day number that is on Yahweh's calendar, his restored calendar, 608. And yesterday, last night's draw was 608. the total with the with that 23 Powerball was 181. Excuse me, that one, the 23 gold ball last night, the gold ball. Wow. What I talked about yesterday, Zechariah and Uriah, the faithful witness twins, those two, that one, 2 1/4 parts that are in the womb of the wife that's fled in the wilderness upon the dual wings of a great vulture to bring them forth. They're in the womb 23 days less than that yesterday. So they're in the womb 585 days yesterday. Is that right? Yeah, 585 days yesterday. Amazing. But he also he caused the 56 number to be drawn last night as well, for as it was in the days of Noah, when opening the doorway point last night, which I believe was the last 10 days of me being bound, my mouth being bound, and him opening wide my mouth. Wow, puts a lot of emphasis on tonight's draw. But he also caused the numbers 1 and 10 to be drawn. And if he's that's amazing. Most talked about waypoint in his war, just about maybe 1-1 is, and 1-10 falls behind it. But the day he set aside the Passover and such, and the day they crossed over the Jordan on dry ground, and the day he gives to his first temple measurements and such, and the 110 years of Joseph's life, the 110 years of Joshua, a.k.a. Yeshua's wife, life, the 110 days of his account of the flood that brings us to the 157th day of his account of the flood, that 717 waypoint that I'm going to get to. It was 110 days after he shut off the rain from 327 to 717. 44 yesterday. Day number 40 was the third number that was drawn in order from least to greatest. Day number 44, I talked about 214. I talked about yesterday's video, how it was the backup Passover, but yesterday's video, that 123 nights for when they got there, the 123 nights of him causing out of that new series of 214 series, just yesterday's video. 47. Yesterday I talked about the 40 days that it will extend from today. Wow, well, that was yesterday was 7 days from, it was on my meditation last night. Yesterday was 7 days from that 717 waypoint. The last seven days of that 490 tier he showed me. That's 47 days from 717, that 9-4 waypoint that I talked about yesterday's video. All drawn last night. And then the gold ball of 23 for that 23 spread yesterday was always a 23-day spread between the number of days for the faithful witness twins, Uriah and Zechariah, and the other 2 4th parts, Meher Shalal Kushbaz and his twin sister Rachel. Truly amazing. But the mega plier, they call it, was 3x to 38. So if you won on the smaller prizes and you paid $1 extra for the mega plier, you get 3 times the prize, but 3 strokes extra, because last night when no one hit, it went up 18 million for the 3rd consecutive stroke. Amazing. 3rd consecutive stroke of the last 3 draws, not the last 3 mega millions, I guess it would be mega millions, Powerball, mega millions. Last 3 draws up 18 million for the 3rd stroke. 3 18s. Wow, how often do I talk about that? Yesterday's video, I even talked about it. Because I talked about yesterday's 666 days plus the 594 days for the plumb line, equaling 318. The day Yahweh spoke to her, those 10 words, parallel on these 10 days, out from the thick dark cloud, the thunderings and lightnings to our ancestors on 318. Just talked about yesterday's video, then last night this happened. Day number 318 of the year was 1118, when he caused his servant Noah to let loose the second dove that brought back the olive branch, symbolic of Yahweh's second son of his holy anointing oil, standing second olive tree, standing before your faces. Tons of things at 318 parallels, but Abraham drew out 318 refined servants to go smite the 4 kings that had smitten the 5 kings, parallel in these 4 applications and excuse me, and over 5 days, and the 5th day of the 4th month parallel for his the beginning of his end time son of Adam prophecies for the rolling thing going into chapter 10, those 4 living creatures and these 4 children and stuff. It's amazing. But the 594 days that began today, day number 1 of them, is Strong's number 594. It's only used one place, and that's Amos 7 plumb line, which I have been speaking now for several months, is him doing 2 of these consecutive draws, 1 in 292 million for the Powerball and 1 in 302 million for the Mega Millions. One in 5, of course, the odds would be much higher than that because it's one person hitting them back to back, and other factors into place that would make it extremely high, especially when he keeps doing it. So, but it's not a coincidence that the plumb line, he's clearly shown every one of these draws he's into, and I haven't even done the rest of the numbers for last night's draw yet. I haven't even reviewed the last couple videos for mistakes. I've been swamped with stuff. Yesterday's last trek, that 212 trek with the rolling thing, which I'm going to touch upon again here in a little bit. But anyway, I did think and meditate about the video yesterday. I realized I made one mistake, and for sure at least one. But I said that 211th trek the day before was on the first day of the seven, like the first day of loading the boat. But I also said that they didn't load on the Sabbath. Well, the first day of the seven was the Sabbath, the eighth day, and the first day of these 7 days, and then until the 211 truck was on the second day. But again, we didn't load on the Sabbath. I didn't do so. It's the same thing there as a technicality, but I did err, even as a technicality. But three months and 22 days from that 402 fig, parable of the fig tree. Quite amazing. Summer's near, and here we are in the summer, and get to the prophecy where summer's over and we haven't been saved yet in Jeremiah, and all that, how that ties into it. But 322 million tonight plus 306 million for the next Mega Millions brings the new plumb line, the new 594, to 628 million. Wow, that is a way cool number, because on 628 of the seventh year Sabbath, he caused his anointed to approach near to him for the 600th day, for those three strokes a day Daniel petitions on at his house before we were removed from there on account of you stealing from him. And of course that's what set up the arrests and everything else, and the court case 29 and the court case 81 to 29 knives and the court case 81 for my face is shining and other things, but lots of other things. But 600 days, as it was in the day of approached near to him, was 628 of the seventh year Sabbath, the year 5999. As it was in days of Noah, 600th year of Noah's life. And actually, oddly enough, the 775 nights with no wine parallels Shem's son that was born to him 2 years after the flood, which takes us to this year, which means something about the breast failing and such, which ties into him. We're holding back these children. Can't remember the exact translation of his name, Arphaxad or something like that. Strong's number 775, but 775 nights with no wine. But ties into the 600 years of the flood, and then him holding this back and shortening the days, or no man would survive. He said in a recent video, follow his drawn out dual nostrils, where he's holding this back, where he's shortening the days, through afflicting someone in your stead. There you'll find the golden oil that pours out from his two sons of his holy anointing oil. That's where the golden oil is to fill your lamps, so that your lives would have light in them instead of darkness. 600 gold, shekels of gold his servant David paid, along with those 50 shekels of silver for the threshing floor. And this is about Yahweh doing the threshing here. Last night's 3x multiplier, whatever. 3x petitions, amazing. That made the 1800th petition that day, paralleling the 318s of last night's. Last night was a third increase of 18. What was yesterday's URL, by the way? Had two numbers in it. 1 and 8, 18. Two numbers yesterday in the URL, the videos. You can really make this up? I'm telling you, he's so unbelievably in control of everything. If you could look at the world through what he gives me to see every day, I talk about a extremely small percentage of the stuff, even to the wife that's fled in the wilderness, because she just can't absorb it all, and neither can I. I take notes and things, and that's why I haven't even got to listen to the last two videos, because it's just... he just overwhelms me. But day number 628 for the 628 zillion or 628 million is day number 178 of the year. He caused our bank account number with Zion Bank, of all things. I didn't know a Zion Bank when we started banking there. I found out later it's a subsidiary of Zion Bank. It doesn't say Zion Bank on the storefront. You can say, oh, he chose that. No, it's in their paperwork. Didn't even realize it till sometimes later. But our bank account number is 0178. You could really make it up. When's day number 178 of the year? That's tonight begins the 628 million plumb line. 18 yesterday, up 18 for the third stroke. Yesterday, on that same day, that third stroke, it went up 18 zillion. URLs, 18. 318 says the 54 years of Hezekiah's life. Say, what? You got to be kidding me with those 15 years added to him with the figs. I used 15 figs over the course of 4 treatments of 5 days. I used to make the ointment. I used 4, 4, 3, and 4, I think was the order of the figs. But it was 15 figs for the over those course of those he made that up too. That's all we had left from the feast, the first month. All we had left was 15 figs. I emptied out the closet. Coincidence, huh? Wow. Parable of the fig tree. Hezekiah with that fig ointment, the healing, and he's sending me with healing on my wings, and of course he's going to heal me. And the timing of that tooth, that left side of my tooth. The night before last night, that's amazing. The night I thought the children were going to be born, but true, it's all quite amazing. What did Adam and Eve do in the garden? They covered themselves with fig leaves, didn't they? Because they covered the shame of their nakedness. Who told you were naked? See, they could see before. So you can see physically, but you can't see spiritually. You can't see His way. You can't see His righteousness, and you can't hear Him, because He's closed your dual eyes so that seeing you see. But don't see, don't perceive, and hearing you hear, but you don't understand. And he says, he's giving you over to your own heart's desires, is the reason he's done that. And you're going to remain that stage until he wastes your cities, until there are no inhabitants in them. Folks, he couldn't send forth the Emmanuel man-child, Meher Shalal Kushbaz, and his twin sister Rachel, and the faithful witness twins Uriah and Zechariah the night before last, because he couldn't, if he was going to continue to shorten the days. He had to draw it out. It's just so, therefore, he couldn't let any of these lotteries hit until now. One man asked when the iniquity of the Amorites was complete, he said, why didn't he just do it the first night with the tickets? The man that was buying the tickets. Well, if he had, him and his children would be dead now, and you and your children was the one that hadn't turned back to him. He's drawn out his dual nostrils, or no man would survive. It's just that simple. And folks, it's just that. So he couldn't do the lottery tickets until now, because no other sign would be given but the sign of the dove standing before your faces with his restored calendar. That's what the sign's all about, his restored Sabbaths and the rest of his restored appointed times. Don't you get it? Don't you get the importance of this all, even the 10 days with the sundial? Because that's how he altered the rotations to start with. That's why the Danites have to put a 13th month every 3 years into their calendar to keep it balancing. That's why the Roman calendar has to add, 31 months in some days, and they 28 or 29 in the second month. Matter of fact, he had me arrested on 229 on his restored calendar. Is it a coincidence that every fourth year they have to, the second month has 229? Every fourth year with these four children with the dual fourth parts? Look at that, 2 years have passed now since that was, and that was, I think that year there was a leap year of the 229. I can't remember if it was that year or the year before, but 2 years have passed since then. Two fourth parts. Huh. Wow. Yesterday was the 2/4 part, Nehemiah chapter 9 prophecy. He couldn't, he's had to keep, like to me and yours did, or no longer shorten the days. No longer, and that means your affliction. That means he's going to give you dual eyes to see and dual ears to hear, because your city is going to be wasted. Because Isaiah 6, which is the beginning of his Meher Shalal Kushbaz prophecy, actually it begins and starts talking about the children in chapter 3. But it really starts to beef it up when he talks about his holy seed in Isaiah chapter 6. He says you're going to remain in that state of not being able to see and hear him until he wastes your cities without inhabitants. Your cities still have inhabitants in them. The diaper email that led to yesterday's waypoint, they add the 175 days for Strong's number 175 for Aaron, his high priest, and 175 years of his servant Abraham's life. The AA waypoint, and you need to check into AA because you're totally drunk off your wine, your fornication gave way. Playing a whore to him, and how it ties into the wine is amazing. And the wine cup, the fierceness of his hot indignation, the King of Kings cup that he's given into my hand. But the 175 days is the 168 days of the day and the 7 days of the hour of the four messengers that were bound in the Euphrates River of the sixth trumpet. Now, what about the year and the month that follow? An hour, a day. A month and a year with 390. Wow, so reverse it, because you have to reverse it, because he's giving it to me to speak the year of the month, the day, and the hour. It's actually the hour of the month, the day, the month and the year, we got 390 days in a month and a year. Well, 390 days prior to yesterday's 175th day, because it's a prophecy, was 624. That is the second of the four waypoints that he gives to us through his Man of the Feast prophecies. And he says, Yeshua, he woke in the spirit up, and Yeshua and Zerubbabel, they did work his house. 390 days laying on my left side by 40 days that follow of me laying on my right side with the uncovering of my arm. It's quite amazing. But that day flows into the 21st day of the seventh month, 27 days later. Said the lowest number drawn last night was 27. Was that, you know, last Powerball? No, last night. No, last Powerball, excuse me. The lowest number was 27. And at 27 days after the 24th day of the sixth month is this third waypoint that he gives to us for the third part of four of Haggai, his Man of the Feast prophecies. And that's the 21st day of the seventh month, the come and drink waypoint. The day that he caused me to start drinking the first bottle of wine of the mount from the mountains of Ararat, which means the curse reversed. And now I'm reversing these 390 days, going back in time to 624 of me laying on my left side to yesterday's 724 waypoint plus 40, taking us to the 280th day of his Zechariah prophecies from the 24th day of the 11th month plus 8 months is yesterday. Plus 40 is 280 days that it takes on average to bring forth a child from the onset of a woman's last menstrual cycle. Amazing. 280th day. And all this yesterday with the 440th and the 441st Silver Trumpet Assembly was yesterday, 440th, the day before, the day they were born. How that ties into how he uncovered the 480 to me long before I knew anything about these children is fascinating. 40 days on my right side, laying on the right side, he gets the uncovering in the arm. You kind of put a nice touch on that with the toothache. And yesterday, me finishing the Rolling Things treks with the 212th trek. First Strong's number for wheel. How do you finish your last trek with the Rolling Thing? When he mentions with the Rolling Thing, the coals given my hand, they were between the wheels. And I finish it on with the 212th trek. Can you really make that up? Can you really make it up? I mean, I hauled as much as I could them treks. And that's just how it worked out. It's just amazing. But yesterday's 2/4 part waypoint of Nehemiah chapter 9, 628 million, it went up to 628 million, the plumb line yesterday, last night it went up to 628 million, divided by the dual 4/4 parts is 4 parts of 157. Day number 157 is 6/7 on our Maker's Restored calendar. Moses' 80th day before he came down. The children I thought were going to be born, those 4/4 parts, were going to be born on 607th day that Maher and Rachel been in the womb. You can't make it up. You just can't make it up. Dual 4/4 parts. You just can't make it up. And then last night he said, well, that's not 158. Yesterday was 608. Yeah, so he caused the five balls to hit 158 last night to remind you of that. But 157 was also the 157th day of his count with 717. Which added this last 7 days it took us to yesterday. 717, the day the ark parked, Noah marked. You really can make it up. The day that the ark parked at the head of one of the mountains of the curse reversed. And 4 days later, of course, is the 721 waypoint, the come and drink waypoint. Which 7 days from that is which where we're at now. 3 days took us to yesterday, paralleling the waters, the separation, the touching to the dead, naked and dead life of an Adam statue. You need to be sprinkled with his waters of separation on the third day and 4 days later on the seventh day, or else you are cut off from being his people. And the waters of separation can only be made with his living waters that flow out from my belly. And of course with cedar and hyssop and scarlet. So that's just in the ashes of a red heifer. And the two of those ingredients, the ashes of the red heifer and the living waters, can only be found one place on planet Earth. And you weren't sprinkled yesterday, were you? No. But amazing, 2/4 parts yesterday, 628 million, the new plumb line, divided by 4, 157. Truly amazing. With that 10th day yesterday, well, I talked about yesterday the 1.47 mile trek with the Jacob route. Jacob lived to be 147 years of age. I go 1.47 miles one way and 1.47 miles the other way is 2.94 miles. What does the 21st day of the 7th month, Man of the Feast prophecy go into? It goes into the 4th waypoint, which is the 24th day of the 9th month, which is day number 264 of the year. But 9 months and 24 days, because it is the prophecy, is 294 days. Wow. What are the odds on the 212 track with the rolling thing? The 212 wheel. Just not amazing. Day number 600 of me approaching near the gateway, three strokes a day, plus 1,106 days was yesterday. Okay, well, you got some significance to it, because yesterday, if you take 11-6 on Satan's calendar of this past year, plus 294 days, you get yesterday. You just can't make it up. What was 11-6 on Satan's calendar? It was the one smooth stone anniversary of the one great evil of Ezekiel chapter 7. The destruction of his house that resulted as you acting, you serving in your the abomination of desolation in Saul of Tarsus' stead by stealing from Gateway and selling anything falsely. The whole repossession, all that of his house, the foreclosure of his house, everything happened on account of you stealing from him. Well, thieves. Caused the one great evil. That was the one smooth stone of it, the anniversary of it. Amazing. And of course, yesterday plus 40 days is huge, which I talked about that, which that be a 904, but that day will be 10-6 on Satan's calendar. The thing that's amazing is because if you take an ad, you add when 11-6 on Satan's calendar is this year, it is 10-5 on Gateway's restored calendar, which 10-5 is the day that he gives to us for his end time Son of Adam prophecy for the city being smitten, no longer having inhabitants in the households. Isaiah chapter 6, I just talked about. City smitten. Fifth day of the season, one escapes from the captivity on 10-6. Oh, did I tell you that 10-6 was 40 days? 10-6 is the 9-4 waypoint on Satan's calendar. 10-6, one escapes from the captivity. And I'm talking about Ezekiel chapter 33. Which that prophecy says that I have to warn you, your blood will be on my hands, calls me his end time watchman, says you're going to listen to my words, but you're not going to do them. And he says you're going to know. And when this comes to pass, whenever you listen to my words, but you won't do them, and behold, it will come to pass, you're going to know that I'm Gateway, he says, or you're going to know there's been a prophet in your midst. I think that one says you're going to know there's a prophet in your midst. But truly amazing. But I'll give you one last thing here, one last nugget that he gave to me last night. What day will these children be circumcised? If they're born in the dawning hours before 9-4, but the 9-4 would be day one, because it's the first day. They would be circumcised, these three man-childs, which, by the way, that ninth, fourth day of the ninth month talks about their four crowns, and talks about Yeshua's crown and my crown, but it talks about the four crowns of these four children. But anyway, that's in three crowns of their heads of their penises, because three of them are man-childs, to be circumcised. But they'll be circumcised on 9/11, Gateway's restored calendar. For 4 years after he was first reviled on account of the manner he sent forth this man-child, 1,440 days for the 144,000. But 9/11. 2001. It goes back to that because that's recorded in his Mahershala Kushbaz prophecy in chapter 9. 9/11, first time he was reviled, and now they're going to be circumcised on 9/11 on his restored calendar. And it's part of the Mahershala Kushbaz prophecy. Could you really make it up? Folks, this is real. You're the naked and dead lives of Adam. It's just what it is, because you're not living by every word Yahweh sent forth from his mouth. And that 24th day of the ninth month prophecy talks about with the robe of a holy man. Everything needs to be sanctified because you've touched all the dead stuff before we can even touch it. So if you look for Yahweh's anointed, find somebody that sanctifies everything that the naked and dead lives have touched. And again, Yeshua said, let the dead bury their dead. I said it, I think, in yesterday's video, the day before, and follow me. He said that if you're not following him, you are the naked and dead lives of Adam with the fig trees. You sow non-figs. Know the parable of the fig tree. It's all come together amazingly with this fig anointment. And now these figs being delivered. And now we got a 10-day, our final 10 days of being bound. And I've spoken all along that 10 days in prophecy is all seven of those called out prophecies for the seven called out ones are different phases of the 144,000 being called out to be Gateway's people. But now we're going to have a final 10 days of being tested with having to wait on Gateway. And did they come to an end this morning, or did they come to the end? And 2 days from this morning, on in the morning of the 20th to 27th, of that. We'll find out as it goes on, see if this video is magnified or see what happens tonight. Know the parable of the fig tree, folks. Fig anointment has been applied. I mean, it's amazing the boils and stuff that he caused me to have and such, and with those four applications, those 15 figs, even that's amazing with the with these 415 prophecy, because it ended the 490 days it took us from the steamboat eruptions, and that whole thing with the steamboat mattress and the Elijah dream. I'm not gonna go into all that, but I checked this morning, and again I forgot to check before I come out here. I keep doing that because I mean I got to set up things for the recording, and I just forget. I get things in my mind, I got the video on my mind, and I forget. But as of this morning, matter of fact, before I even went out here, a little while before ago, I went out here, I checked one more time because I went up to do something, and it was 51 days and 3 hours and 6 minutes, I think, or so. I think it was. I have to look. It would be on the phone still until I refresh it. But it would parallel 306 million for that went up last night to 306 to that 628 million plumb line. Well, all the odds of this come together like this all the way through the whole last these videos. The first one was in 2010 on 12/12 on Satan's calendar. It was on 9/5 on Keepway's then non-restored calendar, which wasn't the same as the Danites calendar at that point, because I realized they were a month off, but it was still using the luminaries that were altered with the parable of the fig tree back then with Hezekiah, with that turning the sundial back 10 degrees and altering the rotations into their current 29.53059 day wobble. I think I said that right. 29.53059 days, I think, is the wobble that it averages over a 19 year span of time. 19 teeth left remaining. I talked about yesterday's video. 19 sons of David. So many things, but I'm going to stop there. But fascinating. You know, the parable of fig tree. It's all coming together, because now we get to Jeremiah. Hey, the summer's ended and we're not saved coming up. But is that talking about us? Or is that talking about you? We're about ready to find out.